My favorite thing about Tradition Mortgage is no question the culture. We work hard and we play hard. We have a staff of very highly competitive individuals that really care about what they do.
If you were to ask why someone should use Tradition Mortgage, I would think with us, you're getting experience. The longevity of our staff compared to the industry averages is off the charts. A recent article in National Mortgage News said that the typical mortgage office has turnover of 25% a year. And the history of our staff here at Tradition and the longevity that they've shown here, you know, you're getting quality people that know the industry.
We're relationship-based and not transactional. We don't have a single product for every client. We really try to tailor each loan to a borrower's specific situation.
What I think is awesome about Tradition Mortgage, what I really love, is the common interest we have in how we give back to our local communities. I would say the large majority of our staff all coaches or manages or does something in the community through scholarships or charity work that we can be proud of.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Care 11.
From sunshine to rainstorms and thunder, even snow, no matter what comes your way, when you think of weather, think of Bell. Chief Meteorologist Belinda Jensen, weeknights at 10 on Care 11.
Always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA.
Good evening, hockey fans. Welcome to Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota. I'm Brandon Spratt, alongside my partner, Mike Greenlay, and tonight's game between the Duluth Denfeld Hunters and the defending Class A champs, Gentry Academy, who are taking the step up to Double A.
They are, and this is their first official game. They played in a couple of scrimmages, so we get to see, we get a bit of a treat tonight. We get to see them take their first step into that Double A. But last year, they outscored opponents 166-20, so they're going to probably try and use some of that offensive power to transition into that Double A.
And on the other side, you have a Class A solid program in Duluth Denfeld, just looking to get over that final hurdle that is Hermantown in their section, but they return a lot.
Yeah, you know, the joke, you have to go through Hermantown, and I guess they have to. They didn't last season, but the expectation should still be there. They have five of their seven top scorers back. There should be, you know, other than, you know, whether there's a player suspended or injured or something like that. But for the most part, they have that core unit that knows how to put the puck in the net. So they should be able to get those guys going this year. The expectation should be there or even higher for this season.
I was able to catch up with Duluth Denfeld head coach Dale Jago a little bit earlier before the game. We'll play that interview for you now, and we'll come back with some of our final thoughts before puck drop on Traditions Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota.
All right, I'm here with Duluth Denfeld coach Dale Jago. And coach Jago, what did you learn about your team first weekend of the season? Coming down here to the Twin Cities, played a couple games.
Yeah, I learned that we can play with anybody. I learned that we overplaying our top guys, and that we were pretty much had a hangover the next day. But having said that, we were at the rink from 1 o'clock to 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock, so a lot of time in the rink, but I think we can compete with anybody in single A for sure, and a few against some of the double A clubs.
So you mentioned, you know, sort of that weekend. You're back in the Twin Cities here again this weekend. What does a weekend like that look for you guys? Look like for you guys on the road?
Well, this is a lot better. I mean, this tournament we were on last week, I mean, it was the first annual, so they learned a lot as far as scheduling. But today, I mean, we'll play at 7 o'clock tonight, and then we'll be at 3 o'clock tomorrow. So, you know, hotels, restaurant food, walks in the morning, guys go for a jog and stuff. It's good for us to get to be on the road. We've been on our first 78 games are on the road, so it's kind of a team bonding thing. But we're trying to a few things away from our home rink as well. So
sure.
It's a learning curve, just like for the players, just like it is for the coaches. Sure.
You mentioned some of your top players, certainly the McClure brothers, you know, would be included in that. Talk about what it's like to have a set of brothers on the team like
that. Yeah, they're dynamic hockey players. They're highly skilled. They can shoot, they can skate, they can pass, they can. It's they're the motor of our team. And they've grown up next to me. I've known them since they were born. So it's just they come to work and to be precise every day, and it plays off. They're going to have a nice future in hockey, so it's we're lucky to have them, and we're lucky to keep them in our program.
You mentioned competing with some of the top programs in single A. Obviously, Gentry's not in single A anymore. They are the defending state champs. What do you expect from them tonight?
Yeah, it's these academies that are popping up. They're getting good players, and they're coming from all over the country. So, it's going to be a good test for us. I don't know where they're at, or they're unknown to me. It's I think the best team in the North in 7A was from the North last year, I think. So it'll be a good test for us. We're excited, and we're excited to play on TV. We're excited for the kids to play on TV. So it's going to be fun.
Thanks, Coach. Coach Jago of Duluth-Denfeld. We'll be back after the break.
All right, we've had the anthems and starting lineups. We're just about set for this one between Denfeld and Gentry Academy. Let's look at our starting goaltenders. First for Duluth Denfeld, they'll be starting the senior, Austin Wick. And for Gentry, junior Anthony Zalesi. Zalesi has some big shoes to fill, replacing Alex Timmons, who backstopped them to an undefeated season a year ago.
Yeah, 19-0 is a pretty good mark. absolutely. But, you know, where there's a challenge, there's also opportunity. So we'll see if he's able to step up. And we said it was going to be a challenging year just because they're stepping up in class. But certainly they have the firepower for that.
So Gentry comes out, top line, Westberg, Reese Shaw, and Brendan Hammer. A couple experienced players on that top unit from the state championship team. And Denfeld has the McClure brothers, Connor McClure, Cooper McClure. They'll play with Caden Postal on the top line. And we are set for hockey. Tradition Companies Hockey Night in Minnesota is underway. Denfeld controls the faceoff. Bangs around at neutral. Blomqvist plays it across to Brady McGinn. McGinn dumps it in, and Zalesi gets his first touch on it. Clears it out to the half wall. That's held in. Now Gentry skates through neutral. This is Westberg. Berg tries to take it around Brady McGinn into the corner. It's cleared out to neutral. Gentry goes D to D. This is Nolan Hyland. Hyland will dump it in. This is toward goal, and Austin Wick will cover.
Well, these teams do have a couple of players that are significant that are not in the lineup. For Duluth Denfeld, Simon Davidson, senior, he's suspended, so he will not be in this game.
Yeah, Denfeld was in the Twin Cities last weekend playing in a tournament. So they're on their third game of the season as a backhand chance comes in. Blocker save made by Wick. And Austin Wick was a very busy goaltender in that. We have an early goal as Gentry takes the early lead. This is Max von Klinggraf with the goal.
Sure, the trainer's happy that they don't have to put the names on the back of the jerseys. So that one would go from elbow to elbow. Right off the faceoff here, just a very good play. And they get it started early. So their AA season is off to a very good start early in this hockey game.
Gentry wasting no time getting on the board first. Less than a minute in, and von Klinggraf skated all the way over to the opposite end to his student section. So great to see the fans back in the stands after last season. Some good energy back in the barn. Early start for Gentry, and this is carried through neutral. Cooper McClure, he's on his backhand. Nice save by Zalesi.
That was a nice little play there by McClure. Went to the net, was being cut off. He still got a good shot up high. He tried to beat the goaltender with a high backhander.
Now going around the cage, trying to jam it in, and Wick was alert to it. He'll cover and get a whistle.
So a couple good chances already for both of these clubs. And Gentry has gotten their season off to a good start here early in the hockey game with a goal by Max von Klinggraf. Sizable kid. He looks big out there too, but you know, a 6'4", just under a couple hundred pounds, and he looks like he's a kid who plays big as well.
Big hit down in the corner. Gentry plays it toward the slot. It's cleared out of there by Braden Erickson, sophomore defenseman. They go cross ice now in the middle. Chance backhand. Oh, and it's put just wide. Good look for Eli Bailey.
Dominic Brennan, a senior defenseman for Denfeld. Nice play there. He played the body, let the goaltender face whatever shot might have come. Ended up pushing him right off the puck. You got to be physical in front of your own net. And Brennan didn't get caught fishing with the poke check. He went there with straight shoulder. Made a good play.
Face off outside the Denfeld end here after the puck was played with a high stick. Top line out there for the Hunters. A record of 1-1. They split the opening weekend. Lost to Champlain Park last Saturday. They'll play another game here in the Twin Cities tomorrow as well against Eastridge. So making the most out of the trips down I-35. Gentry gains the offensive line here. Try to go all the long way around. This is Ryder Betzel, the freshman. Out there standing all of 5'4". Transitioning back the other way. Tried the long pass right side for Postal. Hunter's off for a change. Gentry through their own end. Misfires on the pass, and this will go for icing.
Good back and forth here by both these clubs. Still early for both of them, so trying to establish the pace of their season. Gentry's first game after a couple of scrimmages. Third game of the season for Denfeld.
Denfeld wins the draw. They go behind the goal toward Dominic Brennan. Brennan, I noticed, was on the wing on that faceoff, so getting a little bit creative there. Brennan listed as a defender. Gentry gains the zone and snap shot into the glove from Westberg.
Smart play by Westberg. Just didn't have anything else really going on with that play. Got the puck at the goaltender. He actually used an offenseman as a screen. The goaltender made a good save here, but it's important to force the play to the net. And he did so with a good shot when he had nothing else going on.
Tie up for the puck at the half wall. Reese Shaw comes away with it. Now it's chipped out to neutral. Denfeld has a 2-on-1 at the blue line. Moving in, shot, and a save by Zalesi. Shot in from Andy Larson, the junior, who centers that second line.
Nice little 2-on-1 there. Dominic Brennan was busting down the right side, kind of played decoy. As Andy Larson, the junior, did the right thing. Didn't try and force a pass through the defender, and he got a good shot on goal.
And another shot comes in from the point, this time from Braden Erickson. A lot of rubber going toward the net for both squads early in this one.
Clearly both coaches have said, listen, it's early in the season. We're not ready for fancy plays. We're not ready for touch passes and one-timers as much as you think you are. So get pucks at the net. Make these goaltenders spit up some rebounds. They haven't. But that's the idea.
Gentry out at neutral. Pass cut off there. Nice play by Braden Erickson. Hunter's off for a change. Gentry regrouping in their own end. That's Nathan Rickey looking to start the play. Fires a nice pass offensive zone. Big hit there by Dominic Brennan. Chipped out to neutral by the Hunters. Nice move by Rickey. He glides around another one as well. Tries the toe drag, but eventually is cut off by Brennan, who chips out to neutral.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. What are we, 7 minutes into this hockey game, and every shift that Brennan's out there, you're saying his name. I mean, he's playing a significant role already in this game. Defensively, physically, he was on that 2-on-1, even though he didn't get that pass. Already, when you're announcing a kid's name time after time after time early in a game like that, it tells you that he's focused, he's ready to go.
Yeah, coaching staff mentioned that Brennan was a sophomore they're really excited about on that blue line. He joins a good experienced group, but they really think he could be something special as just a sophomore. This goes out to neutral, played there by Blomqvist, who takes a big hit to dump it in. And Peter Barber, one of the senior assistant captains for Gentry, starts it the other way. They glide through neutral, left wing toward Ethan Joshi, and Joshi's offside at the line. Plenty of whistles here as we're just 4.5 minutes in. It does kind of feel like 7 minutes in, but only 4.5.
Yeah, oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I gotta get my glasses on maybe. Yeah.
But no, there's
early
been a lot of whistles,
yeah,
for
early
sure.
In the game for sure.
This is one out of the faceoff dot. Tyler Guyer with it. He'll snap it D to D. Intercepted by Gentry. Westberg a little bit loose with the puck in their own end. Zalesi aggressive out to play it. Gets the move started. Now through neutral. Berg in the offensive zone. Little drop pass. Played it toward the front. Cleared out alertly by Brady McGinn. Spinning away from pressure there. That was Whitaker Hart, junior winger. Hart looks to chip it out. Diving attempt, and now it eventually will go out to neutral. Not quite yet. Brady McGinn will spin back. McGinn's pass intercepted. Chance for the Stars. Onto the backhand. They score! Reese Shaw on the backhand. And the Stars lead 2-0.
Well, just some failed clearing attempts here by Denfeld, and it cost them. You got a team that can rotate it back offensively like Gentry has shown in the past, regardless of class that they're playing in. And that is a top-line player just finishing a play where it's crashed around the net and just popped it over the blocker of the senior goaltender, Austin Wick.
Denfeld wins the faceoff cleanly back into their own end. That's Nate Larson across to Dominic Brennan. Retrieved there by Andy Larson. Just a relentless forecheck right now from Gentry. They move it off to the right wing. And sounds like Wes Berg actually got the goal. Back the other way, cutting into the middle, and Betzold is knocked off the puck. Now Denfeld through neutral. This is Andy Larson. They'll chip it in deep. Larson chasing after it. Moved along toward Connor McClure. Now battle at the half wall. Couple white sweaters in there. Retrieved. They'll go to the back door with a chance. Brennan and a big save. There's Dominic Brennan again. He gets himself in a good shooting position, but Zalesi across to make the save, and that puck goes out of play.
That could be tough to deal with when you're defending and all of a sudden there's a player that you didn't expect right down by the goal crease, and it ends up being a defenseman stepping down deep and gets himself a good opportunity. And they definitely need an answer somehow here right now, because Gentry is getting a lion's share of the chances and they already have a 2-0 lead.
Loose puck there, retrieved by the Stars. Shot off the goalposts. That was Will Parkinson with a good chance. Brings the post and now chipping it back in the other way. Zalesi out to play it behind his goal. Highland there battling. That's Connor McClure in there as well. Gentry comes away with it. One touch pass that skips off the stick there of Blomqvist. Now big collision in the corner as Blomqvist and Parkinson come together. Come out to the line and eventually out to neutral. Nice play by Logan Nyland. He applies pressure back into the Gentry end. Starts spin away with it. That's intercepted. And here comes Connor McClure. McClure tries to squeeze into the middle, and Zalesi will cover.
Well, we've seen what offensively Gentry can do early in this game, but they haven't given up too much defensively either. Whatever they have, Zalesi has been there to make the save, and he looks pretty poised back there. And you mentioned that he's got big shoes to fill, but you know, he looks pretty poised right now.
This puck is chased down, and a nice save made by Wick. Is just couldn't tell if that was going to go for icing or not. It was Shane Dean chasing it down for the Stars. Now intercepted out of a dangerous area by Caden Postal. Hunters move it left wing. Connor McClure, they're 2-on-2 at the blue line. McClure tries to square it. Pass was behind. Now battling, coming away with the puck is Cooper McClure momentarily. Stars go D to D. That's Ricky. That's intercepted. Into the middle. Chance. Big glove save. As Cooper McClure had a chance from pretty much the circles there, right in the middle of the ice.
And again, when you transition or try to transition the puck out of the zone and you turn it over, which is what Gentry did right there, that puck ends up on the stick of someone in the slot, especially a guy with the abilities that Cooper McClure has. That typically spells goal, but again, another very good, very poised save by Zalesi as he not only stops it, but gives up no rebound.
Stars offside at the line as they look to transition quickly through the middle. Top line out there with Wes Berg, who scored the most recent goal.
That's one thing that takes a little getting used to early in the season, and that is managing the blue lines. I mean, especially the offensive blue line, you want to send your line mates in with speed. A lot of times your timing's not just there. We've seen a couple of offsides in this game already because of that.
This is Reese Shaw, tries the drop pass toward Hammer. And that's off a skate. It'll come out to neutral momentarily. Gentry comes again. Hammer takes a little bit of a bump to dump it in. This is Nate Larson behind his goal. Now at neutral, Nolan Hyland snaps it across. Reese Shaw, or rather Hemmer, and here could be a breakaway, but it just skipped over the stick of Logan Nyland.
Almost caught Gentry on a bad line change there, and a bobbled puck, otherwise, as you mentioned, a breakaway. And that's just a missed opportunity by Denfield not to connect with that pass.
Icing's waved off there. This is Peter Barber. Moves it across toward Geyer. Now spinning back with it behind his own goal, Parkinson. Barber spins under some pressure. As Gentry just plays keep away here. Now they'll look to go the other way. Left side. Into the zone. Now cutting into the middle. Space closed down though, but it's still on the stick of Gentry. Into the opposite corner. Now they'll go behind the goal. Top of the slot, and a shot goes high and wide. That's Caden Millis, senior assistant captain. Now Barber, drop pass, top of the circle. Oh, it was spilled, but I think we got a whistle, and indeed we did. 7:13 to go in this first period. You're watching Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota. And we've had a pretty good one so far. Good pace between Gentry and Duluth Denfeld.
Getting a good look at the Class A champions from last year. Gentry Academy Stars, and you can see why they were able to dominate so heavily last season. Their control of the puck is pretty impressive.
It's knocked away by Braden Erickson. Edged off there at the half wall by McClure, but it's still with Gentry. They'll dump it in. Retrieving it here is John Bloomquist. Heavy on the forecheck again. Whitaker Hart trying to tie up on the end wall. Coming away with it is Reese Shaw. Drops it back to Shaw. He flips it off to the right wing. Snaps a shot in high on Wick. And he'll cover, or squeeze it rather, for the save.
Gentry moving the puck in the zone in waves. I mean, every line that comes out seems to have the same idea. Make a quick little kick out to the wing. Get it over the blue line, whether it's a little drop pass or not, but it's definitely pucks getting to that net and getting at least a faceoff in the offensive zone.
Denfeld able to clear the zone here. This is Gabe Anderson. He plays it off toward the left side for Ethan Joshi. Big collision there at neutral. Here comes Eli Bailey. Weaves his way in. Shot deflects high off the glass. It's still loose. They battle for it on the near side. Comes to the point. Long shot, and that one will be kicked up into the net by Wick. You mentioned Gentry moving to AA this year. They'll be in the section with some traditional powers like Hill Murray, solid programs like Stillwater and White Bear Lake. It's going to be a big-time battle up here in the Northeast Metro.
Well, they'll get tested. There's no doubt about that. And they knew that going in. They certainly feel like they're ready.
Gentry playing an independent schedule as well. They won't see a ton of AA teams in the regular season, which will make things interesting come section seeding time, but that's a long ways off. We got a lot of hockey to go until those decisions have to be made. John Bloomquist to retrieve for the Hunters. They try to play it out left side. That one rolls on top of the dasher. Shot off the end wall. Stars look to cycle it. And it comes to the top of the circle. A shot. I think that might have deflected on the way through from Peter Barber. Good shift here by Gentry. And now Denfeld looking to transition. This is Connor McClure. He sends it around. Whitaker Hart there for it. And it's back with the Stars. Dumped in. Played with a stick by Zalesi. They go D to D. Patiently looking to start up the play. It's intercepted though. Chance for the Hunters. Deflected on the way through from Connor McClure. Now comes out toward the blue paint. Dealt with and sent back the other way. And this one will go for icing.
Well, Denfield still in striking distance here early in the hockey game, but we need to start putting more plays like that. We just saw there on the net. Able to work the puck in the offensive zone that time. And we get an attempt at the net. I don't know if Zalesi was forced to make a save or not, but showing some better signs here than the last few minutes where it was all Gentry.
They control off the faceoff as well. Brennan. And that's tied up. Sent out to neutral by Gentry. Deflected pass. Now the Stars have a chance to transition. That one's knocked off the stick. And here come the Hunters. Weaving through the middle. 3-on-3 at the line. They leave it off left wing. Cooper McClure. Just unable to hold it though is Braden Erickson. Now Brennan. Backhand flip off the glass. This one comes to Nathan Rickey. Rickey on his backhand. Long defender at 6'3". Rickey gets it back, comes to the slot. Backhand. Wick save. It's still loose. Gentry recycles it. What timer? And that hit Cooper McClure on the hand. He's shaken up. Going back to the bench. And we get a whistle. That one looked painful for number 8. Hopefully, he'll be able to shake that one off.
Couldn't really tell how he took that one, but he had his hand palm open towards the puck. It's something that guys instinctively do, and it's a mistake almost every time.
That's a save by Wick on a hard shot. And from the high slot, they battle in the corner now. Looking to dig it out of there. Someone goes tumbling. And they still can't clear. This is with the Stars. Comes into the corner toward Westberg. Couldn't quite get the shot off. They still battle for it. This is Ryder Betzold with it. He dumps it in deep. Played behind the goal by Brady McGinn. Onto the backhand, sent into the corner. Relentless pressure from the Stars on this shift.
Denfield's got to start winning some of these one-on-one battles along the wall. They're losing them, and they're not getting the puck out. Finally, they're able to get that and get a change.
Here comes Whitaker Hart, streaking it on the right wing. Hart with a shot, and it goes over the top of the goal. Off the glass and out of play. That came quickly in transition as Connor McClure just floated a pass up that right side. And Hart failed to test the goalie.
Well, it looked like he wasn't able to corral the puck very easily. And by the time he was able to get any kind of attempt at the net, he was being closed off by a couple of Gentry defenders. And of course, Zalesi, the goaltender, continues to challenge aggressively.
Good stick there by John Blomqvist. Knocks off the stick temporarily. Stars get it back at the circle. This one comes to the point, long shot, didn't get all the way through. Tied up, and another good stick in there by Dominic Brennan. He broke up what could have been a good scoring chance. Now has it knocked off his stick by his opposite number 44. That was Ethan Joshi. Now they tie up near side. 44s are tied up in front of the penalty box.
A great back check. Another young player.
Hammered off the boards. Back to the Stars. Under two to play here in this first period. Gentry with a couple early tallies. Trying to go the long way around. Goaltender gets the stick down. Still can't quite clear the zone. Into the middle. Brennan does a great job again to just get a stick in there. Now it comes to the side of the goal with a chance. Oh, off the goalposts.
Oh,
it's a goal.
A goal, yeah.
And I think it was Reece Shaw that time. That was in and out in a flash. And Reece Shaw, the junior, gets his first of the season, centering that top line.
Well, another example of Denfield just not getting the puck not containing it. I mean, they're poking away at it, they're pushing it up, but just not controlling it. And the loose pucks are being gobbled up by Gentry in this case. Looks like a little bit of a pick in front, to be honest with you. And I'm surprised that the referees didn't nab that one, because Gentry looked like they made a bit of a pick in front of the net on the defender. And that allowed Shaw all alone in front when the puck came loose. But they not only let that go, they called the goal off the post and into the net.
So Gentry with a 3-goal lead. And Reshaw gets the goal. I'm glad he did after I identified him earlier, thinking he had scored. He gets one here.
You were just projecting. That's
right. Shaw's backing in the offensive zone here. He moves it around to the defender. Big hit on the end wall. Comes toward the front of the goal. Braden Erickson away with it. Now carrying the puck through neutral into the offensive end. That's Andy Larson. Coaches said that the junior Larson is probably their best player. He played in the Upper Midwest High School Elite League here in the fall. Normally he'd be centering a line with Simon Davidson, the leading scorer last year for Denfeld, but unfortunately Davidson is out tonight, as you mentioned earlier. This comes to the side of the goal, flipped over the top in the final 20 seconds. Cleared out to neutral. Retrieving it is Marcellus Krueger. First time we've called his name tonight. One touch pass right side. Half wall deflected on the way through. Final 5 seconds. Denfeld just looks to clear the zone. One final chance comes in. And it's a big save there as a loose puck ricocheted to Von Klinggraf looking for his second.
Well, 3-0 is a tough hill to climb. 4-0 with 0.4 seconds left in the period would have been pretty tough, but they survived that. They're down 3-0. Gentry, a very good showing here in this first period. And Denfeld just needs to manage the puck a little bit better out of their own
zone. Yeah, a lot of shots coming in from Gentry. Austin Wick made some big saves despite the score. And Anthony Zalesi wasn't asked to do a ton, but looked pretty impressive in doing so. So 3-0 Gentry at the end of the first period. We'll take a quick break here for our first intermission. We'll come back in a little bit. We'll have some scores from around the Metro. We got a few other games going on the MNHockey.tv that we want to inform you about tonight. But this is Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota that you can get on all your Care 11 platforms, Care 11 YouTube, and also the MNHockey.tv. Again, thank you for joining us tonight. And we'll be right back with our first intermission. 3-0 Gentry Academy with the lead over Duluth Denfeld.
My favorite thing about Tradition Mortgage is no question the culture. We work hard and we play hard. We have a staff of very highly competitive individuals that really care about what they do.
If you were to ask why someone should use Tradition Mortgage, I would think with us you're getting experience. The longevity of our staff compared to the industry averages is off the charts. A recent article in National Mortgage News said that the typical mortgage office has turnover of 25% a year. And the history of our staff here at Tradition and the longevity that they've shown here, you know, you're getting quality people that know the industry.
We're relationship based and not transactional. We don't have a single product for every client. We really try to tailor each loan to a borrower's specific situation.
What I think is awesome about Tradition Mortgage, what I really love, is the common interest we have in how we give back to our local communities. I would say the large majority of our staff all coaches or manages or does something in the community through scholarships or charity work that we can be proud of.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Care 11.
From sunshine to rainstorms and thunder, even snow, no matter what comes your way, when you think of weather, think of Bell. Chief Meteorologist Belinda Jensen, weeknights at 10 on Care 11.
always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA. Always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Carolina.
From sunshine to rainstorms and thunder, even snow, no matter what comes your way, when you think of weather, think of Bell. Chief Meteorologist Belinda Jensen, weeknights at 10 on Care 11.
The history of Tradition Capital Bank goes back to 2005. There were a couple different companies in existence already, Tradition Mortgage and Tradition Wealth Management. And I had known Eric Hendrickson, the president of Tradition Mortgage, another gentleman by the name of Reed Evenson, knew a gentleman by the name of Tip Ennebeck, and said, hey, how cool would it be to start a bank someday to really serve our clients, not only on the mortgage side of things, not only on the wealth management side of the business, but to have a bank that can serve all their needs. And so we literally, with a group of investors back in 2005, $10 million of capital, started Tradition Capital Bank. Since 2005, we've grown every year, year over year, just taking care of clients through relationships. We're all about relationships at Tradition, and we want to take care of our clients well. We started with $10 million in capital, and 15 years later, coming into our 15th year of business, we are now an $850 million bank that has a business banking division that serves small business clients. We have a private banking division that serves clients individually. And we also have a construction development and mortgage business that works nicely with our other companies, providing housing to thousands of people year over year. At Tradition, we're a high-touch, high-tech bank. And what I mean by that is we have one-on-one relationships with all of our clients. When you walk in, we know you by name. Yet, when it's Saturday night and you're working on things, you can do online banking, mobile banking, and have access to all of the technology that all the big banks have to offer. So you get the best of both worlds, high touch, high tech.
Always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA.
Welcome back to Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota by Care 11. I'm here with Mike Greenlay. Our first period intermission summary. First period was dominated by Gentry on the scoreboard. They were really effective in the neutral zone and in the offensive zone.
Well, they came out with a lot of heat then. They scored two goals pretty quick in the hockey game. It kind of set Denfield back on their heels a little bit. And then from then on, you could sense that they were giving pucks away and not getting the puck out of the zone like they should. They were losing one-on-one battles in their own end, and Gentry kept taking advantage of getting shots. They finally got their third goal, but it wasn't until late in the period. So, I mean, Denfield needs to manage the puck a little bit better and get themselves into the offensive zone a little bit more consistently.
So paint me a little bit of a picture. What are some adjustments that Denfield can make? You just mentioned a couple, but...
Well, you need to possess the puck a little bit more, and that means puck support by everybody. And whether it's the defenders stepping up and helping the forwards through the neutral zone, or whether it's just everybody being more aware of where the puck is and how they can help each other out, because you need to come up the ice sometimes more as a unit rather than just that. They do have that top line, that one top line that moves the puck really well, but not everybody plays like that. So you have to think more of a team mentality. If they can manage the puck a little bit better, they'll find themselves getting through the neutral zone and into the offensive zone as a unit, and maybe they'll get themselves some more puck support and some more shots on goal, because I'll tell you what, Zalesi has played very well so far in net for Gentry.
All right, that's our first period summary. We'll be back in just a couple minutes with the second period. For now, a quick word from our sponsors. Thank you for watching.
My favorite thing about Tradition Mortgage is no question the culture. We work hard and we play hard. We have a staff of very highly competitive individuals that really care about what they do.
If you were to ask why someone should use Tradition Mortgage, I would think with us you're getting experience. The longevity of our staff compared to the industry averages is off the charts. A recent article in National Mortgage News said that the typical mortgage office has turnover of 25% a year. And the history of our staff here at Tradition and the longevity that they've shown here, you're getting quality people that know the industry.
We're relationship-based and not transactional. We don't have a single product for every client. We really try to tailor each loan to a borrower's specific situation.
What I think is awesome about Tradition Mortgage, what I really love, is the common interest we have in how we give back to our local communities. I would say the large majority of our staff all coaches or manages or does something in the community through scholarships or charity work that we can be proud of.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Care 11.
We get set for the second period here from TCO Sports Center in Badness Heights. I want to thank some of our sponsors for coming along with us for Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota. Of course, Tradition Companies. We also want to thank Sniper's Edge, City County Credit Union, TRIA, and St. Cloud State University, some of our fantastic sponsors, to allow you to bring this game to you tonight on the MNHockey.tv YouTube page and Care11.com, Care11's social platforms, and more. Second period set to get underway here in Badness Heights for the defending Class A champions, Gentry. We mentioned they're in Double A here this season.
Impressive first 20 minutes for them stepping into Double A hockey. And this obviously showing a lot of talent and depth throughout their lineup.
So shots on goal unofficially in the first period. 17-5 is what we heard. 17-5 in favor of Gentry in the first period. That sort of backs up the eye test, if you will.
and that's where that number needs to even out a little bit more if Denfield is going to have an opportunity to get back into this game.
Good news for Denfeld is Cooper McClure was back in on the faceoff dot there. We saw him leave in some pain late in the first period after blocking a shot. But good to see him back out there. Nice pass through neutral. This is Brendan Hamera. Leaves it left wing. Spinning back with it is Reese Shaw. That comes into the middle. Now toward the top of the circle. Long shot. Rebound. And it's off the outside of the goal. Good early chances. They try the one-touch pass toward the slot. Still loose. Now Shaw, that one comes through the blue paint and pushed wide. And as the net comes off, it's Austin Wick pouncing on the puck as we get our first whistle.
A couple of extra pokes at the puck there and to McClure. Cooper McClure takes a couple extra shots at one of the Gentry forwards who was looking for a rebound. Goaltender Austin Wick did a good job of just jumping on that. He could sense that the pressure was mounting. The Gentry Stars had a few opportunities and were looking like they were all over the puck, and that's going to cost McClure a penalty. I don't see two guys in the box, so he's the only one I think who was going to get the gate unless they go grab the other fella off the bench.
There is a conversation down at the bench in front of us.
They're going to grab my okay. They're saying, I think they are, at least.
Yeah, it looks like it. So yeah. They're going to send Brendan Hamer as well.
Okay, because that's who McClure went after. And where's that?
Oh, it's
actually, I think that's Berg.
Excuse me, it's Berg.
West Berg. Yep. So he went after him behind the net there. And so they'll give them both a couple here and have them take a little timeout.
A little bit of a breather there. We'll still skate 5-on-5 after the coincidental minors. First penalties of the game. I was almost ready to say that we went the whole period without a penalty, and then we got some coincidentals here to start the second. No power play, though. And here comes a nice move through the zone. In on goal, and Zalesi.
There's a hooking call there for sure. He had broken in there all alone, and he draws the penalty, and maybe a good penalty to take, but that's definitely going to cost Gentry a couple minutes here. Yeah, boy, they showed a lot of speed right there. And that was Andy Larson, who really broke through the middle of the ice and got around the defender, only to be hooked right as he was about to shoot that.
Yeah, very nice one-touch passing through the middle of the ice there. So now Denfeld is on the power play just over a minute into this period. It's Gabe Anderson, junior defenseman, who gets to sit for a couple minutes. Power play here. First of the game for either team. And it's for the Denfeld Hunters, the visitors. And that's knocked away. Could be a breakaway here. Caden Millis in on goal. Millis and a save made by Wick.
Well, Gentry won't be denied, apparently, even when they're shorthanded.
This is Andy Larson. He weaves his way into the offensive zone. Now back to the point. They'll go back to Larson. Up top for McGinn. Moves it. Now toward the corner. They'll go back up top. McGinn's shot deflected on the way through, and that'll go up into the net out of play. Gentry will change some skaters on their penalty kill. And Denfeld changing some attackers as well. Caden Postal into the faceoff dot. It's a tie up there. Gentry comes away with it, and they'll hammer it off the glass. Send it 200 feet. Austin Wick will play it. He comes under some pressure, spins it back to Andy Larson. Larson through neutral, now into the middle, and teammate kind of got in the way, and they'll turn it over, and banked off the boards, back the other way. Another chance for Gentry, shorthanded, and does Wick have it? He must. He does, and he'll move it. We'll keep going. That was Brendan Hamer, who had a chance shorthanded.
There's only been two shots on this Denfeld power play, Both of them have come off Gentry sticks on breakaways.
This is Hemmer with the third, and that one sneaks in. They score. Hemmer with the initial shot. I think it was going to go in, but Shane Dean made sure as he put it across the line. Shorthanded goal, Gentry, who leads 4-0.
That's a killer for Denfield. I mean, they had to look at that power play as an opportunity to get back into this game and instead gave up two breakaways, another shot that squeaked through, and a 4-0 lead.
And they have it off the faceoff again as well. This is Ethan Joshi, the senior. He makes a nice move, knocked away from his stick, but Denfield will just look to regroup. They only have about 25 seconds remaining on the power play. Now Reese Shaw from a tight angle tries to center it across, and now Denfield has some numbers here. They're 2-on-2 with the line. Knocked off the stick nicely, though, by Peter Barber, who will clear. John Bloomquist sets up behind his own goal. That will do it for the Gentry power, or rather the Denfield power play. Gentry leads 4-0. They go right wing, gaining the zone here. This is Shaw. His pass misfired. They hold in at the point. Long shot is tipped. Now Bloomquist. This will go all the way down, and it will be icing.
Always curious how teams respond now to both sides, really. How do you respond to having a significant lead? How do you respond to trail a game by 4-0? And usually you see a little bit of character that comes out of both sides because of that. See how they respond to this. And also we'll see how much ice time Gentry will throw to other players.
Backhand goes high and wide from Ryder Betzel, the freshman. As Gentry just keeps coming here, no matter who's on the ice. They've been extremely effective. Back the other way, snaps a shot, and Zalesi had a big pad save there. Shot coming in from Connor McClure. This dangerous top line for Denfeld. One-timer for Brennan, deflected, and they score. There's that response you talked about. A good shift for Denfeld, and Dominic Brennan gets a goal.
That one definitely deflected. I'm not sure off of whom, but it definitely rode right up over the shoulder of Zalesi. So we'll see if Brennan does get credit for it, but he did shoot it. But he brings Denfield back within three here with a nice shot from the blue line.
How important can that goal be just to see the number change, right? To just get that zero off the board.
Well, it's a response to a bad power play. I mean, a bad power play where they gave up a shorthanded goal and you kind of even that one out. So, granted, they got a long way to go, but at least they were able to kind of knock that one off the board and respond to it.
Toward the goal, Wick gets down and makes a save there. Now comes the high slot, getting just a piece of it. Caden Millis snapping a shot off, and that one might have found the corner if not for getting a piece of it there for Wick. Now how about Gentry responding? They're right back on the attack. They respond to the Denfeld tally. Battle in the corner. Brennan ties up for the Hunters. They'll move it along. One-timer, they score. It's Caden Millis. He's been close a few times. And a beautiful one-time feed from Von Klinkgraf to Millis. And that's a response right back by the Stars.
Well, quite a bit more of the same here as Denfield once again gives up too many loose pucks in their own zone. I mean, just coughing up pucks or loose pucks in areas where, you know, a guy can spin around like that and fire one over the shoulder of the goaltender. 5-1, now 4-goal deficit again.
So Caden Millis gets the goal. He has 28 now in his career. One of the more experienced players for this Gentry Stars team returning, that is. They lost a lot off the state championship team from a year ago. Still plenty of talent, of course. And it seems like when they have the puck in the offensive zone, they're playing from the hash marks in behind and using areas behind the goal to great effect. We saw that there. They set up that one-timer in the slot. They'll hold the zone here on the far side. And moving the puck along there was John Blomqvist. Gentry holds the zone, though. And Blomqvist will clear that one. Only as far as neutral. Now circling back in is Reese Shaw, who gets dumped. And Shaw thought that should have gotten a penalty there, but I think it was offside at the line. So faceoff just outside the Duluth Denfeld end. They'll make a late change with the forwards. McClure and Bailey tie up. One back by Denfeld. Blomqvist will bang it off the wall and dump it in. Icing waved off. Selezy will move it along to the far side. Big hit coming in there from Cooper McClure. One-on-one on Blomqvist. They try the wraparound. It's loose. They score again. Loose puck banged home. I think that was Peter Barber getting up in the play. The defenseman. And it is senior Peter Barber, 6'1".
These goals are starting to look very similar to one another. Ends up being a loose puck or a turnover on the back of the net.
That time it was Shane Dean, the junior forward, who started it, made a nice play, tried to jam it home on a wraparound, and as you said, Peter Barber just gets that loose puck first. And there's another loose puck, could be a two-on-one. Backhand, and save made by Wick as Brendan Hammer, I think, went for the one-handed finish there.
Austin Wick is going to feel shell-shocked here because it's just a wave after wave in front of him. 17 shots in the first period, and we're looking like we're trending towards that here in the second.
And Wick faced a lot of shots last weekend as well. He saw 63 in two games for the Hunters. Going to see another load here tonight. They have another game tomorrow taking on Eastridge. That's intercepted at the blue line. Held in. Shot deflected into the corner. We reached the halfway mark of this game yet, and Gentry picking up right where they left off last year. Scores like this were pretty common in their 19-0 undefeated season run to a state title. Denfeld goes D to D. Try to bang it out off the boards. A couple maroon sweaters, a couple white sweaters in there as well. It eventually comes loose to a Gentry skater trying to make a move toward the front. Poke checked away by Wick. He can only clear it as far as center ice. Tyler Geyer with it. Geyer loops his way into the offensive end. From a sharp angle, that's saved by Wick. Now to the front, loose puck, Blomqvist. Zone still held. Now loose in the slot, backhand out of there. And Zalesi's going to come way out to the top of his circle to play it. He looks to start the break himself. And they have some numbers here. Denfeld on a change. Toward the back post, they score. How easy was that? Von Klinkroff gets his second goal of the game. But how about the goaltender Zalesi there? I think that could have gone for icing, but he said none of that. Looked to start the break himself. And leads to a goal. I think he'll get an assist.
He should. What he recognized is Denfeld having to make a line change. and they desperately needed one. They're in their zone the whole time, and when he saw the whole crew headed towards the bench, he made the headman play, and then only the defender was, one defender was left. It ended up being something like a 3 or 4 on 1, and that's why the goal looked so easy. And it's 7-1 now, and timeout called by Denfeld to kind of help these guys regroup a little bit.
That was a tough sequence there for the Hunters. It just, sometimes when you're on the back foot, it just seems like no bounces are going your way, right? A couple times that shift, they try to clear the puck, it just hits off a shoulder. Just what can you do to stop this momentum? But they'll try here and call a timeout and see if they can come out with some energy here. But Gentry, 3 goals in a row since Denfeld got one back.
Well, defending is, it'll take more energy out of you than playing offense. And so that's why you always want to have that puck in the offensive zone. Even if you're not getting chances necessarily, it's an easier way to play. And when you're defending, you're circling, you're always moving, and your goaltender's got a ton of crouch time to worry about. And that's what happened there. They just got so tired, they weren't able to clear the puck. And when they finally did try and make a line change, well, Zalesi, the goaltender for Gentry, moved the puck up the ice, and it ended up being an odd man rush and a goal.
And here comes Denfeld. Shot from a tight angle. Zalesi poked out of there. Zalesi with another save on Brennan, who was going for his second goal. So Denfeld with a good response there. They had a quick 2-on-1 with Andy Larson. Dominic Brennan trying to follow the play. Here comes Gentry. Snaps a shot off the pad. That was Brendan Hammer, who's been effective tonight playing on a top line with a couple veterans. Hammer in his first varsity game has not looked out of place whatsoever. Spinning in behind. Try to jam it on the wraparound. Gentry will transition here. Dunks behind the play.
Brennan's going to get a penalty there. Kind of submarined one of the Gentry players. Ended up being Reese Shaw.
Yeah, pretty easy interference call for the official trailing the play there.
I'm sure you'd have to do more than that to upend a guy like Reese Shaw. He has 4 older brothers. When you're the fifth, when you're the fifth brother, you're either really tough or really, really cagey, or both.
Well, he looked a little cagey there, didn't he? John back with Brennan. They shared some chirping back and forth there. So a clear there early. This is Gentry Academy's first power play of the season. We're just past the halfway mark of the second period. Gliding into the offensive zone here. And now it's turned back to neutral. Nolan Hyland will play it. Hyland's back in his own end. Lays it off to Tyler Guyer. This is still Guyer. As they look to wind it up. Here comes Ryder Betzold. Betzold, the freshman, gliding in. Takes into the corner. And he'll chip it toward the other side. This is Will Parkinson. And Denfeld clears it again. Guyer retrieves it back in his own end. 50 seconds gone on the power play. Pass across to Betzold. That's intercepted. Nice stick check, though. Wins it back for Gentry. Hammer, drop pass. Spinning with it here is Westberg. They go to the point. Hyland comes back to Hyland. He drags inside one defender. Will curl at the half wall. Up to the point. At the circle. Backhand shot and save made by Wick. That might have been deflected out front. I couldn't tell if Hammer maybe got just a little piece of it, but Wick will cover and get a whistle.
Gentry's still 40 seconds left on that Dominic Brennan interference call. They're still working on a power play. They lead it 7-1.
Gentry wins the faceoff, but getting to it first was, or rather, Denfeld wins the faceoff, but Gentry gets there first. It's off a skate into the corner. Hammer will move it toward Reese Shaw. And cleared away. That's Cooper McClure. Chasing back after it the other way was Caden Postel. He'll try the long pass. Chipped in there. and Wick will get on top of it, seeing the attacker closing in quickly.
Yeah, if I'm Austin Wick, I'm covering everything. I mean, absolutely smothering every puck that I can legally get away with, because you know, any momentum you can slow down from the Gentry Academy stars, the better.
And Denfeld has been pretty good on the faceoffs tonight. They win another one there, but again, Gentry gets possession. Big time battle out front. Moved into the middle, backhand, blocker saved by Wick. That was a nice set play on the drop pass. Back to full strength are the Hunters as Dominic Brennan out of the penalty box. Almost able to pick the pocket there. They sent a couple forwards high on the forecheck. Now Dominic Brennan will chase. 6 minutes to go here in the second period. Nice pass through neutral. That just rolls off the stick of Reese Shaw. Shaw's driven hard into the corner.
Man, was he ever taken hard into the wall.
And that one's deflected up into the net out of play. Shaw a little slow to get up as he was taken in hard by his opposite number seven, John Bloomquist.
Well, they went shoulder to shoulder. And Reese Shaw lost his balance a little bit and went heavily with his right shoulder into the boards. He popped up pretty quick and made it to the bench, but he's got to shake that one off.
Faceoff will come outside the zone after Gentry deflected a shot out of play. They go D to D and they'll try to dump it in. That's gloved down and back at neutral. Nolan Hyland has it stolen, moving in on goal, and that's Cooper McClure who's taken down hard. No penalty. Oh, there is a penalty call. Excuse me.
Well, Cooper is the one who, I believe, hurt his hand on that blocked shot earlier in the game, and he is, again, down in the corner, and hard to say whether it's the same ailment or whether it's something new, but penalty is coming up here to Gentry's number 12, Shane Redenbaugh.
So Denfeld's back on the power play here. Denfeld hasn't had a ton of chances, but when they have, a lot of them have been like that, those breakaways and half breakaways. One-on-one with the goaltender. McClure's back in the faceoff dot, though, and Zalesi makes a blocker save. So Cooper McClure, a little bit shaken up, but he's out there again. He's taking a little bit of a beating here tonight, but still out there. Wick will leave it off for Dominic Brennan. Hunters into the offensive zone. This is McClure chasing after it. He'll get there first. His pass is blocked. Trying to go cross ice. Now into the middle. Just put wide there by Caden Postal. Now Postal gets there, and it's going to be cleared. Wick comes out of his goal to play it. Teed up for Andy Larson. Larson's long pass. This is Postal. Just in offside there. They'll have to regroup at neutral. Postal spins away from trouble. Now it's Brennan. Winds up for the slap shot. Hard off the end wall. Deflection. And now it's back the other way. One-on-one. This is Von Klinkroff. Tries to get off a backhand pass, but Larson angles him off nicely. And now a long pass could send Postal in. Caden Postal for Denfeld. And it's over the top with the blocker. And looks like the net is off. It was Postal racing in on goal, but he had to slow down, lost his momentum, and Gentry was looking to catch him up from a trailing position.
Defender did a good job there. He pressed down on the stick. That tripped him up and knocked him into the goal post and created the whistle.
Forty-one seconds of power play to go here for Denfeld. They'll send Caden Postal into the faceoff dot. It's off left of Zalesi. It's won by the Hunters. Brennan goes back to the point. Now they have it at the half wall with McClure. Comes near side, back up top, one-timer. That's deflected, didn't get all the way through. Big one-timer from Andy Larson. Now regroups in his own end. McClure has it knocked off his stick, and we're going to get another penalty on Gentry, I believe, for tripping. So Cooper McClure draws another one, and this time it's Caden Millis going to the penalty box.
Now, Denfield hasn't made them pay for any infractions yet, and so therefore it doesn't appear to be that harmful to do so. We'll see if they're able to do something with a two-man advantage here.
There'll be a brief 5-on-3 of 22 seconds for the Hunters. And then they'll go back to a one-man advantage. This comes to the point. Cooper McClure. McClure toward the circle. They try for the tip out front. It was close. Dominic Brennan, big body out front there. Now comes Andy Larson. His shot deflects off a shin pad and out of play.
Oh, good block there by Geyer. Paid the price a little bit, but that's what you have to do when you're killing a penalty.
Yeah, Geyer comes to the bench. He'll be replaced by Brendan Hammer out there. And Gentry will be back to 5-on-4 shortly. So they get one player back. It's Nolan Hyland, who's almost got in behind the defense there. Nice play by Andy Larson. And neutral spins back with it. Intercepted in the middle. Larson will still hold the zone. Now in behind, Cooper McClure. Up top. Plays catch with Larson. Larson walks down. This is Postal. Another block shot by Gentry. Comes in behind toward Dominic Brennan. Now Connor McClure, far side. Plays catch with Larson. Larson winds and fires, and I think Dominic Brennan tipped that one from right in front of the goaltender, but Zalesi up on top of his crease makes the save.
He certainly hasn't given up a lot of freebies. That's very clear. Zalesi's freezing on that puck, ending that play whenever he can.
Under three to go here in the second period. 45 seconds of power play for Denfeld, who has to regroup here. This is Andy Larson. They turn it over. Snaps a shot that's high off the glass. Larson under some pressure. This power play unit, this five has been out there a long time for Denfeld. Kicked out by Wick on a dump in. This is one thing that Coach Dale Jago mentioned in his interview that you would have heard in our pregame, that he sort of played his stars a little bit too much. They wanted to mix it up a little bit more in this game, but yet I think they've really only been running about 1.5 lines in this game, especially here on the power play. As Gentry back to full strength on the backhand, they try to go back door. They're almost connected, and Gentry will ice the puck here. Oh, it's going to be waved off last second. John Blomquist under some pressure. He moves it right side. John Blomquist off the boards. Gentry back into the offensive zone. Pinned against the end wall there. It's Nolan Hyland getting in on the attack. Comes to the top of the circle, and it's pushed just wide. Big collision down in the corner. Now they tie up again on the end wall. Gentry's done some really good work down below the goal line in this game. They seem very comfortable there. And Denfeld will ice the puck.
It's been a lot of power play penalty kill in this second period. See if things kind of get back to normal a bit. And play some even strength hockey for a while. There's only 55 seconds left, but it's been primarily a special teams.
Long shot and a blocker save made by Wicht. Now on the backhand, poke checked away. Now it's knocked down in front, played with a high stick. Trying to get it out of there. Now it's Gentry's turn, now that they're back to 5-on-5, and they're going to be, well, spoke a little too soon. Yeah. We're back to power play here. This time it'll be the Stars as Eli Bailey is tripped up. Braden Erickson, sophomore blue liner. He's going to go to the penalty box for tripping. And Gentry get 35 seconds here on the power play. Failed to click on their first power play opportunity. This is their second. Tie up in the faceoff dot. And that one will be out to neutral. 24 seconds in the period. Gentry gained the zone at the blue line. Patiently waiting, head up. Reese Shaw looks to find a pass. And that's banged off the glass out to neutral. Maybe time for one last rush if they hurry. Tyler Geyer, 6 seconds. They will have some time. Comes left wing, they're onside. Long shot from Shaw. It's squeezed by Wick. And we have some extracurriculars after the horn. And the officials will have to sort that out. Might get some penalties out of that. As looked like the goaltender Wick and one of the Gentry forwards got into it, and then things kind of transpired from there. But 7-1 at the end of the second period. As our officials continue to discuss.
Frustration on Denfield's part. And Austin Wick felt he probably has had enough pressure in this game so far and didn't need anybody hovering over him at the end of that play, although they didn't make contact.
Right. So a minute 25 of power play time coming in the third for Gentry. We'll wait to see what the officials decide to do here. We're going to take a quick break. End of two here at the TCO Sports Center in Vadnais Heights. It is 7-1 in favor of Gentry Academy playing their season opener here, coming off the state title a year ago. We'll be back with the second period intermission report in just a little bit, and we'll get you some updated scores from across the metro. Thank you for joining us. This is Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota on Care 11.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Care 11.
From sunshine to rainstorms and thunder, even snow. No matter what comes your way, when you think of weather, think of Bell. Chief Meteorologist Belinda Jensen, weeknights at 10 on Care 11.
We're going to do the right thing. And that comes from the top down, and it, you know, permeates throughout everything that we do. It's just one part of it. The other part is the absolute total commitment to giving back to the community. Everything that we do is driven by how we're going to make the world a better place. It's paramount into what we do, because we know that long term, you know, having a focus on the customer is what's going to make us a long lasting company and group of companies here in the Twin Cities.
I think we're a phenomenal company with an amazing team of people. So much talent, so many creative minds, and really good quality people to work with, which make it fun. See, we're very focused on customers. You're looking at from the designs that we are creating on a regular basis and constantly enhancing, personalizing, modifying when necessary in order to accommodate our customers' needs. The other thing that's great is we're always cutting edge, looking for new ideas, new trends, new plans. What's the next great community or product line that we need to focus on that will take us into the future?
Always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA. Always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Care 11.
From sunshine to rainstorms and thunder, even snow, no matter what comes your way, when you think of weather, think of Bell. Chief Meteorologist Belinda Jensen, weeknights at 10 on Care 11.
Thank you for watching Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota, streaming live on the Care 11 apps, care11.com, and the mnhockey.tv. Just want to come back and give you some quick scoreboard update from across the great state of hockey here on a Friday night. First, we go out just a little bit east of here at the St. Croix Valley Rec Center. Pete Wagner's out there for a big single-A game between the East Grand Forks Green Wave and the Matamidi Zephyrs. It's Matamidi with a 3-0 lead after two periods, but East Grand Forks out shooting the Zephyrs 22-10. So that could be a good third period there. Obviously, we know Ben Dardis, a fantastic goaltender for Matamidi, seems to be putting in some good work again tonight as the Zephyrs lead after two. Minnetonka girls hockey, they're one of the top-ranked teams in the state. They currently hold a 5-1 lead over Apple Valley. That is, I believe, in the third period at some juncture there. So Tonka, again, looking really strong. They lead 5-1 in the third period. And try to get one more here for you. There's some big games going on this weekend at the St. Louis Park Rec Center. Big tournament there. Hill Murray tonight played Eden Prairie at 6 p.m. And Hill Murray came away with a 4-1 win. So Hill Murray gets the win. They will play, says Hermantown tomorrow. I think Hermantown and Benilde still to play here tonight against some big games out at the St. Louis Park Rec Center. So that's your scoreboard update here. Be sure to tune into games all weekend on mnhockey.tv. We got some really good ones coming for you, especially those ones out at the St. Louis Park Rec Center I was talking about, but all over the great state of hockey coming up this weekend. As we get set for the third between Duluth, Denfeld, and Gentry, just want to thank our sponsors one more time. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by Tradition Companies, Sniper's Edge, the City County Credit Union, TRIA, and St. Cloud State University. We'll be right back with the third.
I always like to call myself a sports storyteller. My philosophy for doing sports is to be thorough. I like to go behind the helmet. I love to talk to athletes and hear their stories. Catch me every weeknight at 10 on Care 11.
From sunshine to rainstorms and thunder, even snow, no matter what comes your way, when you think of weather, think of Bell. Chief Meteorologist Belinda Jensen, weeknights at 10 on Care 11.
I often think about why someone wouldn't want to be part of Tradition Companies, really. But for me, it's being part of a group of companies and people that will always want to be better and do so without ever cutting any corners, right? I've been here 12 years and I kind of feel like a youngster at times. I mean, for the most part, because we have guys in Ennebec Construction that have worked for us for 35, 40 years.
It's just being involved with a brand that you can really stand behind and what it stands for. The quality, the not cutting corners, the customer-centric approach to all of the business entities.
Always on, always moving, always connecting. With a top-rated app that lets you deposit checks and transfer money anytime, anywhere, City and County Credit Union is here when and where you need us. A fast, safe, and contact-free way to manage your money. No matter where you are or what you're doing, be in control of your money with a checking account designed for life on the go. Because life is busy. We get it. Let us help. Visit City and County Credit Union to get started. Insured by NCUA.
And we're back for the third period here on Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota. This is our second Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota of the year. Second of the week, actually. You got a double dose of Hockey Night in Minnesota this week. Gentry leads 7-1 over Duluth Denfeld after two periods.
Yeah, it was the first game that you mentioned. The Edina Hornets girls were able to defeat Holy Family Catholic by a 4-0 score. So they took care of them and appear to have another solid team as they defend their title from the season before. And I guess they defend their dynasty. I mean,
yeah,
four titles in 5 years is what I call a dynasty. And
I would say so. Are we sensing a theme of the early season games here? We got defending state champs on Hockey Night in Minnesota.
I don't mind it at all.
The very best, right?
I don't mind it at all, and neither team has disappointed. Gentry has clearly had a very good evening. They lead it 7-1. And, you know, from Denfield's perspective, you know, come out and just try and win the period. I mean, that, you know, you're not going to necessarily come back in a 7-1 game, but win the period. Come out and win the period and at least prove to yourself that you could be competitive for this 20 minutes right now.
So shots on goal in that second period were 14-6 in favor of Gentry, so pretty similar to what they were in the first period. I believe that's 31-11 through two, if my memory serves me correct. It might not, but so we come back for the third as we are skating 4-on-4. So the only penalty at the end of that period was against Gentry. They send the junior number 17, Tyler Geyer. We didn't get any announcement on penalties there after the skirmish at the end of the period, but it is Gentry sending one to the box. We're 4-on-4 to begin the third. That's dumped in deep. Back to retrieve it is Andy Larson. Larson comes under some pressure. Shot and a goal. Reese Shaw with a beauty up and over the shoulder of Austin Wick. And it's another one for Gentry. It's 8-1.
Well, that was a snipe. Over the blocker from an angle like that. He's a right-handed shot as well.
I'm glad you said snipe. We might be seeing that one again in our post game for the snipe of the game. Yeah. You never know.
We have eight choices, so we'll figure one out.
So it's Reese Shaw, his second goal of the night. As we have entered running time here in the third period, so 15 and a half minutes remaining. And that clock will continue to roll for the rest of the game. As long as the margin is 5 goals or more, I believe, at the high school level. Battle there at neutral. Denfeld is back to full strength here, so they have a brief power play. Nice move there at neutral. This is Shane Dean. He'll just retreat and allow his team to get back to full strength. 5-on-5, 15 minutes to go here in the third period. This will go as icing on the Stars.
Gentry has got to be happy with the way that they've played this hockey game. A good first outing here in their 2A class elevation.
Yeah, one of the late starters. A lot of teams getting started over the Thanksgiving week and Thanksgiving weekend, but Gentry waiting until Friday night here. Home opener in front of the home fans. They've had some pretty good support as well. Good to see the students out here. This beautiful facility, Gentry Academy itself, is just across the parking lot, which I actually didn't know until I drove up here, but Long pass through neutral. This is the mark and turn back to the Stars. They'll go cross ice, enter the zone. Shot comes in. That's Von Klinkgraf. He got the first goal tonight, got things started for the Stars, and they haven't looked back since. Denfeld got one to make it 4-1, but last four to the home team in this 8-1 game. Stars' next game will be against Armstrong Cooper, coming up on December 7th, so sometime next week. They'll be over at the New Hope Ice Arena, facing another single-A squad. Face off to the left here of Anthony Zalesi, who has been pretty impressive in, not his varsity debut, but debut as a starter. He carries some pretty strong numbers over from last year, was a perfect 5-0, giving up 0.4 goals per game, had three shutouts, and saving over 95% of his shots. I think that's pretty good. Not bad numbers, as we actually have a goaltender change for Denfeld as well. Junior Martin Hoffman's in the game, and he makes a glove save there.
Nothing against Austin Wick. I mean, he faced a heck of a barrage in the first couple periods, and just an opportunity to get Martin Hoffman a little bit of ice time, and there could be as many shots.
That one deflects, doesn't get all the way through. Pass comes right wing. This is Caden Postal, who will send it into the opposite corner. Hard battle there with Andy Larson. Defended well there by Geyer. Now Geyer skates away with it. Pass deflects off a skate into the Denfeld end. Chipped away by Dominic Brennan. Now that one's off of Brennan. Loose puck will come into the corner. Eli Bailey, loose puck side of the goal. Still with the Stars. They'll try to go toward the back post. Bailey from a tight angle sends it wide. Trying to spin another shot toward goal, and now eventually Dominic Brennan will loft it down the ice. Teammates change. Here's Tyler Geyer. Geyer weaves his way in, lays it off right side. Reese Shaw. Shaw's backhand pass is knocked away. There's Hammer. And now Cooper McClure with it for the Hunters. He's under heavy pressure there from Reese Shaw. Now banged off the end wall. Trying to go out the other way with Dominic Brennan. Still Gentry with the puck, and that's out of play.
Well, even though they lead 8-1 and they've scored the only goal of this period, Gentry seems to have taken the foot off the gas just a little bit. Not a lot. They still look like they're managing the puck really well, but they aren't doggedly pursuing the puck. And we've got a couple shots in on junior goaltender Martin Hoffman. See how we finish this hockey game. As I said, Denfeld could do everything they could to try and shore up their game.
Loose puck here at neutral. This is Eli Bailey. And they just strayed a little bit offside with Ethan Joshi on the near side. I think Denfeld, to their credit, too, they have skated hard all night as well. Just been overcome by, really, the team speed of Gentry Academy. It's something to see, for sure. I think that was the case last year, too. They had obviously put up great numbers, have a lot of great players, but they just keep coming at you in waves and waves. Every player in this lineup is capable of it, and it seems to be an identity, a style of play as well, as much as they're talented players, but they're just relentless in pursuit of that puck. Credit to head coach Joe Cullen, his assistants Andrew Martins and Tyson Fulton. They coach both the varsity and the junior varsity roster. That's why we didn't get a chance to meet with them before the game. You're wondering why we missed out on the Gentry coach interview. They were busy coaching away in JV when we were trying to get those interviews. But I want to thank the Duluth-Denfeld coaching staff. They were very gracious with us. in the lead up to this game, left us with some really good information and some good notes. So thank you to the Denfeld coaching staff. And Gentry have been fantastic hosts for us here as well. It's dumped into the opposite corner by Nolan Highland. And that one rides the glass all the way down. From Blomqvist, it'll be icy.
As you mentioned earlier, that running clock peels it down pretty darn quick. But we still spent a good portion of time down in the Denfeld zone in this period.
There's Dominic Brennan. Try the drop pass there into the middle for McClure, but three white sweaters in the area. Able to knock the puck away. They're going to be offside, so they'll look to regroup. Snapping a pass off right side. Goes through the stick of McClure. Will Parkinson onside. Now Brennan moves it off to the left. It's with the Stars. They're on the backhand here toward the back post. And
oh, what a save.
Somehow.
Tremendous save there by Martin Hoffman. He reached back with his glove and somehow got what should have been a tap-in into the open net.
Well, I didn't see that one myself, so good eyes.
Yeah, he's, well, I can always appreciate a good save.
And on the other end, I know we haven't called his name a whole lot in terms of the play, but Anthony Zalesi, what stood out to you about his game tonight? Looks like he's going to be the starter this year, replacing Alex Timmons, who was excellent, but I think Zalesi's been pretty good in his own right tonight.
Just poised. You know, he doesn't seem to be shaken by... Let's not get this wrong either. Denfeld did have some good opportunities in this game. Not as many, and not as frequent, but definitely some opportunities, and Zalesi just handled them expertly, and in many cases didn't give up any kind of rebound where you could build off of it. So he was very poised. Heads up goaltender, obviously, in the second period when he made a nice play to notice that there was a line change occurring for Denfeld. He fired the puck up the ice, created a 3 or 4 on 1 that ended up in a goal. So good game so far by the young netminder.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that play up. It was a really fantastic heads-up play, as you said, and it just really speaks to just how this team plays, just nonstop on the gas. And even the goaltender wants to have a part of that. Is he could have just let the puck go by for an icing, but instead looks to start a break. And I think he should get an assist for that. I'm pretty sure he has had the secondary pass for that goal, but hopefully gets proper credit. Anyway, Denfeld's back to the power play here. We're already down to 5.5 minutes remaining. McClure looking to start something out of his own end. He's turned back. Sends it across to Blomqvist. Dominic Brennan will dump it in. Battle here on the near side with Cooper McClure. Now Andy Larson, he scores! What a shot by Andy Larson. He gets his third goal of the season in 3 games. And Denfeld on the power play gets another one, making it 8-2.
Well, you can tell that Zalesi was trying to look out one side of a player, ended up being shot on the other side of him. Good job by Andy Larson to use the defender as a screen there.
Yeah, and Duluth Denfeld assistant coach Jake Johnson, who, by the way, is the all-time leading scorer at Duluth Denfeld High School. His words about Andy Larson said he was a gifted hockey player with great speed, superb puck handling, and a great shot. We saw that great shot there as Larson gets his third goal of the season. And then for this Gentry side, I think we'd be remiss if we didn't talk a little bit about Barrett Miller, who's not in the lineup tonight. He's going to be back in the lineup here soon, but he's looked at as probably the best player on this Gentry roster, and they've been impressive tonight even without him. Saw an article that Miller is actually, he's being looked at in the sort of the preliminary rankings for the 2022 NHL draft, so that's the type of player that Gentry will be getting back here in the next few weeks. It'll be interesting to see how they match up with some double-A teams. I know they're going to play Holy Family at some point this season. I think Blake as well.
And those will be good tests for them as well. I mean, I know that they can clearly run amok on a few teams, but there'll be teams that find a way to slow them down a little bit and answer.
Loose puck brought away here by Denfeld. That's McCourt just out of his reach there. It's Reese Shaw knocked off his stick. Into the middle for the one-timer, and Zalesi had to be alert. Blocker save. It's loose, but Barber controls. Barber takes a bump on the end wall. And neutral, they'll dump it in. 2.5 minutes remaining. 8-2 in favor of Gentry. 1-1 here in the third period. As you mentioned at the beginning, what can Denfeld do to win this period? They've drawn it so far. Maybe they can get a late goal here, but Gentry might have something to say about that. Another save by Hoffman as it's flipped up in the air, loose in the crease, and they score. Ethan Joshi, I think, hammered that one home, number 44. And Gentry has 9. Lead at 9-2.
Another loose puck has cost Denfeld in front of their own net. And that's been the theme of the game for them. I bet you that if you were to roll by every one of the goals, you'd see quite a few of them are created by loose pucks or turned over pucks in the wrong part of the zone.
Yeah, tough one for Hoffman as well. He made a nice blocker save there, and unfortunately the puck just popped straight in the air. Joshi was first to react. Gentry lead at 9-2 in the final 100 seconds here. In this one, this is Reese Shaw. Try to center it toward the front of the goal. Oh, and intercepted there just in the nick of time by Nate Larson. Icing on Denfeld as Zalesi sends the puck all the way back down. We're in the final minute of this one here tonight from Badness Heights. Denfeld looks to clear out the far side. Larson applying some pressure. This is Dominic Brennan. Brennan will dump it in. Zalesi plays it. Tie up on the end wall. 25 seconds remaining. Moves it up left side to Will Parkinson. And this is Shane Dean. Dean's ball toward by Blomqvist. He spins back. Sends it across toward the circle. Final 15. Looping back with it is Larson, or McGivelry, rather. Now this is Dominic Brennan in the final five. He'll bang it off the glass, takes one final hit, and that will do it here from Badness Heights. Gentry Academy opens their season with an emphatic 9-2 win on Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota on Carroll 11. It was a good one here tonight, but Gentry showing their strength. Any final thoughts?
Well, they did a lot of things right. They controlled the puck. They did everything with speed. The goaltender locked it down when they needed help, which wasn't that often, but still, he did so. Just a very, very skilled team, and they showed it here at Denfeld. Also a good team, but just too many mistakes, and a team like Gentry will definitely jump on those.
So now we're It's time for our Sniper's Edge snipe of the game. As you said, we had a lot of choices in this game, but we ended up, we're going to go with the last goal, I think, or rather second to last goal that Gentry scored, as Reese Shaw just put it right up over that right shoulder of Martin Hoffman on the near side. And you see it right here. Nice goal by Reese Shaw. He also ended with two tonight. He's one of the stars here of this Gentry Academy Stars team. And Reese Shaw gets the Sniper's Edge snipe of the game.
That's a pretty good shot from an angle. Right-handed shot down the left side. He still managed to get it over top of the goaltender's right shoulder up underneath the bar. So put it in a very small area.
All right, so that's going to do it for our coverage here from the... Oh, and just a reminder, our player of the game went to Max von Klinkroff, a big power forward for Gentry. He scored the first goal of the game and ended with a couple. He's a load to stop for opposing teams, and we're going to give him the player of the game here tonight. So for Mike Greenlay, I'm Brandon Spratt. Thank you for watching Tradition Company's Hockey Night in Minnesota by Care 11. We've enjoyed this one. We've done a couple this week. We'll come back with more games throughout the season. And thank you for watching. Have a great rest of your evening. Gentry wins it 9-2 over Duluth-Denfeld.